Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to Carpo Gaming and another Marvel's Avengers video. Well, today we had so much information that has been dropped on us concerning day one with the Avengers that I had to make a video to keep everybody informed in the community. So today we're going to go over everything that you need to know about the launch and day one when it comes to Marvel's Avengers, and there is quite a bit. Now to kick things off, there is a new war table that is starting on September the 1st. Now this is a preview for early access people, so be sure to watch that up and coming war stream, and throughout the whole week there will be a ton of updates, so be sure to check right back here at Carpo Gaming for more news, tips, and tricks when it comes to Marvel's Avengers. Now, what is included on day one? Well, there will be a huge patch, so just know that you're going to need to download this patch before you start to play. Now, after you've updated, you can expect a full-length campaign featuring an original Avengers narrative, 6 heroes, each with 50 plus skills to upgrade, plus gear and outfits to unlock, 80 plus war zone / drop zones missions to play with your friends or with your AI Avengers, and regularly updated priority horn challenges and priority missions. Remember, this is an online game, so it's going to have that feel that things are always alive in the world. They're also going to have late game mission types like hives and villain sectors, plus 50 enemy types to master. And in the future, new playable Avengers like Hawkeye, as well as a whole bunch of other ones that I covered in a video as well. Now, in addition to all of that I just mentioned, they also wanted everybody to know that your Square Enix membership is required with the day one patch. So you need to create yourself a Square Enix member account. So for those of you that have already played the beta, you are good to go. But for those of you that hasn't played the beta and are looking to get this game, you should hop on that right now. Go ahead and create yourself a Square Enix account, so that's something that you don't have to do on day one. Now, co-op, let's talk about it. Co-op access on console. Marvel Avengers feature co-op gameplay with up to a total of 4 players and is a standard practice for all consoles like PlayStation and Xbox to have online access in order to play. So you're going to need PlayStation Plus and Xbox Live if you want to play online, but you absolutely don't need it in order to play the whole game. It's a little tricky, but you are going to need it to access it on day one. So, I mean, it is what it is. Early access. While Marvel's Avengers launches officially September 4th, a 72-hour early access is granted for those who pre-order one of the 3 editions. You got the PlayStation Store exclusive digital edition, the deluxe edition, and the Earth Mightiest edition. For early access eligible digital editions for Marvel's Avengers, the game will unlock on September the 1st on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One at the rolling midnight release, on Stadia September 1st, 9 a.m. PDT, and on PC September 1st, 9 a.m. PDT. So yeah, rolling midnight PlayStation and Xbox One will actually get to play this first, unless you have a digital code that was gifted to you by Square Enix giving you access to the game right now. But hey, not at Carpo Gaming, we're not there yet, but we'll get there one day. Now, next up, we have what is coming at launch. So what is coming at launch? Well, at launch we have a one-time internet activation and day one patch. Like I mentioned earlier, they go on to sell you quite a bit of information, so let's get with it. Those who purchase a physical copy of Marvel Avengers will need to connect to the internet one time in order to download the game's day one patch. So you can't even download the patch unless you connect to the internet just one time. Now, the patch is approximately 18 gigabytes in size. Those who purchase the game digitally will receive the patch along with the game's initial download, which is reportedly around 90 gigabytes. So you're looking at 100 gigabytes. So basically Call of Duty Warzone. when it comes to the Avengers. Now, after the day one patch download is complete, an internet connection will not be required to play the game solo. Although, as mentioned above, you'll need an active internet connection to play online co-op and to download post-launch content, including new heroes, new missions, and new regions that are going to be free. Now, while they are able to adjust the development to work from home quickly, they did lose a bit of production, so they are including all of this stuff in the day one patch. Like I said, the beta had quite a few issues, and the day one patch will include several updates to these things that we experienced in the beta. So, they also will have 15 different languages as well, so everybody should be covered around the world. The day one patch is also important as it includes a lot of fixes, feedbacks, updates, and tuning from the beta over the last couple weekends. I know I definitely submitted some things. We'll see how things will turn out. So, when can you get it? Well, they also wanted to give an update to the global servers when they go live so you can know exactly when you can play the game. Now, from the beginning, an overall vision of Marvel Avengers has always been one where players will assemble online to protect the Earth and battle against AIM as a team. Now, while the entire game can be played solo with companion AI, the game has been designed as a seamless online experience where players would transition from the single player campaign to joining with friends in co-op missions as part of the Avengers initiative. So, as a result, everyone will need to wait until the servers officially go live on September 1st to start playing. But I'm sure if you have a code from Square Enix, you'll be able to play early, as most big time YouTubers and other media outlets get those early codes. So they're just talking about consumers, us, you know what I mean? Carpo Gaming is still small time. Now, they have also said that it is important for us to know that matchmaking servers need to be populated because this is a co-op, fully integrated part of the experience. So they want everybody to get in there and have internet access and enjoy the game. Now, remember, this is Square Enix first attempt at an online only type of game, so we will be experiencing some technical difficulties. Every company and every game that does this type of thing experience lots of difficulties at launch, so just be aware of that, but let's hope for the best. Now, they also said tomorrow they will run everything you need to know about the accessibility in Marvel's Avengers, followed by an overview of online gameplay on Thursday and a rundown of gear and cosmetics on Friday. So every day they're going to be doing something different, so I'll be posting different videos so you can stay up to date when it comes to Marvel's Avengers. Now, last but not least, they will have a beta post-mortem on Saturday and a look at the weekly gameplay ritual on Sunday. And don't forget, then that following Monday will be September 1st, where they have early access, and it will be a new Avengers War table, which they will show off Hawkeye and a whole bunch of other stuff as well. So, once again, stay up to date right here at Carpool Gaming. I upload a ton of different videos, news videos, giveaways, and all kind of other good stuff like that, from Marvel's Avengers to Destiny 2 to future games that is up and coming. But for right now, Marvel's Avengers, I got you covered. News, tips, tricks, and a whole bunch more when the game launches starting next week. But for right now, that's pretty much going to end it for the video, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I hope you truly enjoyed it. Now, if you are new to this channel, don't forget, hello. Welcome, don't forget to subscribe. But if you are new to this channel and you want to help out, well, you can do so by liking the video if you indeed like this video and the content, and leaving a comment down below. Look, I upload daily videos, I answer all of your questions as well, like who else is doing that on YouTube, and I do a ton of giveaways as well. Speaking of, I have another giveaway coming up for Rogue Company, so make sure you look out for that video coming up very soon. Once again, thank you everybody for all your love and your support, and as always, I'll be seeing y'all in the next one. Later.